next speaker is likewise an independent media leader, as well as a comedian, the host of Get Your News On with Ron. And I'm very grateful to him, Ron Placone, and Graham Elwood for hosting our organizers at their live comedy events back when that was a thing. they were very gracious in always in any venue that they went to providing a table for MPP organizers, and very thankful for that. And so I'd like to introduce to you now, Ron Placone.
Thank you very much, Nick. I appreciate it a lot. Thank you. We are here today because we realize that, you know, people say, oh, the system's broken. Here we realize, no, the system's working. The system's working the way it's supposed to. It's working the way it's supposed to for the donor class and for Wall Street. It's working so well, it's gotten to the point where our options for president are Joe Biden or Donald Trump. Like most people with a pulse, I don't want to vote for either candidate for a lot of reasons. One of them being, I have a cat. I already spend enough time checking a box for a piece of shit. And it's not unreasonable to say the only time people should be having to choose between alleged rapists is if they're picking someone out of a suspect lineup, not voting for a leader of the free world. And this is the point that it's gotten us to. This is by design. It's by design. During the Democratic presidential primaries, there was more talk about having empathy for billionaires than there was about stopping the systemic people by police. We've reached a point where people like John Kasich and Colin Powell are part of the supposed alternative to the conservatives. At the rate we're going now, by 2028, Don Jr. is going to run for president as a Democrat. I don't know who the Republican nominee is going to be. I'm guessing it's going to be a hologram of Mussolini. I'd imagine that'll be the front runner. And this is by design. The Republicans are one of the greatest existential threat to mankind, to paraphrase Noam Chomsky. I believe that to be true. And the only way they're able to be this horrible is because of how ineffective the Democrats are. And vice versa. They need each other. And that's bipartisanship. It takes a Republican wing and a Democrat wing for the American Eagle to fly so it can shit on all of our heads. And we're here to say it's time to end the duopoly. We're here to say that it's not radical to demand the type of healthcare system the rest of the industrialized world takes for granted. It's not radical to say we need to act bold on climate change now with the Green New Deal and it can't wait. It's not radical to say anybody working 40 hours a week at an honest job deserves a living wage. It's not radical to say we need to look out for the most vulnerable among us. It's not radical to say that education should be for everyone and not just for the elite. And it's certainly not radical to say it is time to end the wars and end them now. And I want to give a special thank you, first of all, to everyone here today, because you're all so amazing. But in particular, there are some of the speakers today that have done so much to educate myself and everybody else in the world, really, about what the United States is doing around the world, because that's a job the corporate media refuses to do and won't do. And that is why I personally am not for any war unless I'm willing to go fight in it myself. That's why the only war I am for is the war on drugs. I'm fighting for drugs. I think we're going to win, actually. I'm feeling good about it, and I'm doing my part one joint at a time. But we are here today to say it is time to end the duopoly, and we cannot settle for less. And the time is now, because if not now, when? Because at the end of the day, my friends, there is nothing pragmatic about an incremental solution to a catastrophic problem. My name is Ron Placone. You can learn more about me at ronplacone.com. Thank you very much for allowing me to be part of this. I love you all very much. Peace.